Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel where I do K-pop reviews, rankings, and recommendations. Today, we will be discussing my favorite comebacks of July based solely on my personal taste. I am not a music critic, nor do I claim to know the technical side of music. I just know what I like and what I don't. If you're interested, I also made a video for my least favorite comebacks of July, and also a video reviewing Nugu comebacks from this month. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button if you want to see more videos from me. And with that, let's get to the reviews. It was good. Different than I expected, but still really good. By the third listen, it started to feel a little slow, but I think that it's a nice, solid track. Her vocals are also super clear, which I love. You got me drumming, drumming, drumming. The girl's a longer time vibe. Objectively, I really liked this song. I wish the chorus was a little more sung rather than shouted, but it's fine. Would I go back and listen to it on my own? Probably not. But it's still a good song. I did not expect to like this song as much as I did, considering that I haven't liked any of their other music so far. It was a nice change in pace for them without completely changing up their vibe. I always liked their vocals, so it makes sense that a chiller song would work well for them. The only thing was that the lyrics at the end of the chorus felt a little flat, and I can see this song not aging super well. But I could be wrong. Super Junior has proven they still have it if given the right song. It was fun and trendy, but didn't feel out of place and cringy like some of their other recent releases. It was a nice summer track from an older group, and I appreciated it. The production overpowers the vocals a little, but overall, I love the cutesy, magic, fairy girl aesthetic and 2015 vibes. I'm really hoping that K-pop takes a sharp left turn next year towards this style of music, because I love it. Okay, I'm ready, but I'm not stupid. I'll try. Halloween in July? Absolutely. It sounds like a Tim Burton song fused with a Billie Eilish song, and I'm here for it. The only thing I wish is that they went bigger with the bridge and final chorus, but overall, it was really great. This is surprising because I never rate their songs this high, but I genuinely really liked it. This song was absolutely stunning. Leave it to WJSN to save the whole year with a mermaid concept. This could have easily been too much or too little, but it was balanced perfectly, and I can see the song standing the test of time, or maybe even getting better over time. I preferred Life's Too Short, but considering that their songs always take me 5 or 6 listens to appreciate, and I love this one after 3, I think it has the potential to dethrone Black Mamba as my favorite title from them. It does sound different from their other comebacks, but it's okay to try new things without losing your core style, and I think this album was a great example of that. This was miles better than their debut, and I'm really glad they're leaning into their pop-punk sound rather than toning it down like some bands do for their Korean audiences. The only thing that kept it from being a 10 was the rap. It felt a little out of place, and I'm not the biggest fan of raps and band songs, but it's still one of my favorite releases this month. This song was so wonderful. Even the weird tempo change in the bridge felt fine on second listen. It was really relaxed, yet still really addictive. Not too in your face like a lot of the other K-pop songs from the past 2 years. There were a few releases this summer that had a more laid-back style, and I really hope more artists will start doing it. This is exactly what I wanted from their return. I was worried, but they never let me down. It was just as fun and ridiculous as I was hoping, yet still very endearing. The I love you in the chorus could have become annoying, but with every listen, it just got better and better. This shouldn't be a surprise because I love Billlie and retro, but I love this song. This is the type of weird camp songs we need in K-pop, and Billlie is definitely delivering. I know it's just a remake, but it's still very on par with their other releases. The views are low compared to their other music videos, but I guess it's not a traditional comeback, so that makes sense. This was such a great sentimental pop song, and with each listen, it just kept getting better. It was definitely a nice and well-needed switch up in their sound without losing their signature style. It's a great example of how groups should be evolving their concepts. I have a feeling this song will eventually be one of K-pop's timeless tracks. This was so much fun. It's surprising because I didn't like their debut at all, but this song is the epitome of my K-pop music taste. It's my favorite style of music, and I hope they continue down this path. It didn't take itself too seriously, yet also took itself seriously enough to sound genuine. It also fit their age range well and didn't feel too mature for them as an artist or for K-pop's core audience of teenagers. Yet it didn't sound childish or too immature for the older members either. Why did I like this so much? I've never liked an AT song except for Wave, but I love this song. Why is it my favorite of the month when other similar songs are ranked in my worst comeback list? I'll tell you why. It's because the instrumental and the vocals are well balanced and don't compete with each other for attention. It's well written and does an underappreciated concept well, without simplifying the sound. They committed to the concept and did it well where some other examples this year failed, and all the parts sounded genuine to the style they were going for. To me, it sounds like they did it because they wanted to, not because it was a trend, and that's what makes it genuine. Also, the music video itself could get a whole video with all the references they used, the most prominent being the Metropolis references, but there's also some made towards works of art and other dystopian media, including the symbol for anarchy. This is definitely the most surprising turnaround for a group this year, and I'm excited and a little nervous to hear what their next comeback will be like. And those were my favorite comebacks of the month. I tried to be as unbiased as possible with my opinions, but let me know if you agree or disagree down in the comments section. Don't forget to check out my other review videos for this month, and subscribe to see more videos like this. Bye!